Oftentimes, people have approached me and said that they wanted to reduce their life insurance in order to contain some of the cost on their budget. Well, is that a good thing or not? Well, it really depends on your situation and where you are at in life. I typically recommend term insurance when clients want to talk about insurance. And over the years, what's happened is the cost of term insurance has actually gone down because the average life expectancy of people has gone up. Now, term insurance can be issued from 1 to 30 years, and then it stops. You can renew and get another policy, but often at much higher premiums. Second, you need to decide when you look at this whether or not you need life insurance, because some people might not need any life insurance. Let's say you're retired, you don't have a problem with your income in retirement. Most people in that situation, no need for life insurance. If you're younger and you have a family, you might need a lot more life insurance and for a longer period of time. So let's talk about some questions you might want to ask yourself and get the answers to in order to help you determine how much and how long. First question is, how much money would you or your spouse need if one of you were to die? What about children? If you have children, what about taking care of those children? Maybe the spouse that's left behind has a full-time job and you have to hire somebody to take care of kids, child support and that sort of thing. Are you going to pay off the mortgage if one of you passes away? Are there other debts that need to be paid off, like car loans and credit cards? What about college costs? If the children are young, are you going to fund their college through life insurance proceeds if something happens to one or both of you? Burial expenses are typically what people think about, but that, for the most part, is not a very large amount of money. Then you take a look at what life insurance coverage you may already have in place when coming up with a need, like through your employer. Group term insurance is oftentimes offered as a group benefit for no charge. Unfortunately, when you leave your employer, usually that benefit goes away, and you may not be able to replace it with coverage on your own, especially if you're uninsurable. Also consider other expenses that might be there, and for the real wealthy, there are estate taxes that can be paid for by life insurance. Your assets also count, because you can certainly use those if something happens to you. That lowers the need for life insurance. Once you make the final decision and you've got it in place, take a look at it every few years, because things change in life, and so does the need for your life insurance.